M writes, "Hi Collider team, my question is related to the recent backlash around the amount of spoiler footage shown in trailers. Do you think that a big studio would have the guts to release a major movie without any trailers at all? I'm thinking particularly with BVS. Would seeing no trailer have changed your views on the film? Surely just calling a movie Batman vs. Superman is enough to get people in to see it, and would this increase the box office also?"
Josh, what do you think?
This is one of those things I'm kind of passionate about, because I thought a movie like Southpaw was ruined by the trailer, because that was a really, really well done movie. I really enjoyed that movie. Kind of cookie cutter, but really well done. I think a movie like Batman v Superman, there's so many people talking on so many blogs about things that everything is going to get spoiled regardless.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, minute 37 is when Wonder Woman shows up and da 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 da. So I think in those kind of movies, the trailers are what get you super excited. They get you, they have those oh wow moments. Would Batman v Superman had more wow moments if they kept Doomsday out of it, or even kept Wonder Woman out of it? We talked about it on Schmoes last night, sure. But I think you kind of have to put at least like a little bit of teaser in there. I think there's a really happy ground that we need to reach, and we're not there yet.
Jason?
You know, 10 Cloverfield Lane released one trailer before that movie. And that one trailer for a movie that I don't think most people knew even existed, that got me so excited for the movie to see it just off that one trailer. I think it is possible. I think if you craft a great trailer, one great trailer, I think there's enough there. But I can understand why studios aren't like that, because studios are like, we can't bet it all on one thing. Right. We can't. We got to make sure. Like, we spent so much money on this. I do agree with you that Batman v Superman could have shown us less. Mm-hmm. I think Star Wars could have showed us less. I'm a little worried, right? I hope there's more to Civil War, because I'm worried. I'm kind of worried that I've seen like the end battle of Civil War now, and I'm, you know, and I wish they hadn't put Spider-Man in the trailer. But it is a happy medium. There are certain movies. I think Star Wars could have done it. I think Force Awakens could have just gone off the original teaser, and then that's it.
I was actually fine with them they released that teaser. Then they had like another trailer.
Did they show like Star Wars Celebration?
Yeah. And then they showed one more. Mm-hmm. I was fine with that. It was what happened was after they showed that one on Monday Night Football, they showed like all these
everything.
TV spots.
Everything.
They just totally. There's no way. There's no way a movie studio would ever not release a trailer. That's a box office suicide.
Yeah.
Like the trailers are so important that there's a reason why they have to have them play in front of other movies. Like, they are so adamant, even though technically, let's say a TV spot reaches X amount of people, like millions of people, and let's say you throw a trailer in front of people who are watching a movie and it's less, but they know those are the dedicated movie fans. Those are the people that are willing to come out to see it. So they have to show something to those people.
They also
at least.
They have to do that because of also middle America, because we love movies here. Everybody watching loves movies, but not everybody in America is like us and sees every single trailer and every TV spot and reads every article on Collider. Like, they don't do that.
And on the flip side of that too is you could get an amazing trailer and the movie be really terrible.
Yes.
True.
Which has happened more times than not. I loved your comparison about 10 Cloverfield Lane, because that is one of those trailers that got me excited to see that movie. The movie totally paid off for me. But there's got, you know, like Deadpool, that whole marketing campaign without a trailer, and they were just these cool PSAs. Mm-hmm. I think that's one of the things that movie studios aren't doing, is thinking outside the box marketing-wise and creating some really cool viral campaigns or campaigns that reach different audiences. I think that marketing gets stale in a lot of these studios, and they're just like, listen, we have Batman in the title.
Yeah.
Let's just throw out a picture of
that. Or they lean on the press junket, and they're like, the press junket's going to do it all. And it's like, and Deadpool did really prove that, like, you do something unique with your marketing and you will really make people believe that there's something more to this movie that we haven't seen. Also, Deadpool had the advantage of being an R-rated movie, so they couldn't put a lot of the jokes in the trailers.
Yeah.
That, and it was a unique circumstance where that type of humor for that marketing campaign totally worked. You can't do what you did with Deadpool with Batman v Superman.
No.
Even if it was rated R, you still couldn't have done that.
But they hit on it a little bit, because like the Turkish airline ads were a smart way to do it. They could have done. They've done some stuff where they did LexCorp, the Forbes ad, and then I saw that they just released like an Instagram photo where it was like Lex Luthor's mugshot, and it was the statement from LexCorp being like, "We disavow our CEO." So I'm like, "Oh, is the viral campaign still going on?" Like, that's the type of stuff to me that intrigues people, and that's they dip their toe into it, and they should have just stepped into it.
Making these movies real life as opposed to a movie.
Yes, yeah, yeah, a viral, a real life experience. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But I agree, they should kind of pull back on them. We don't have to see, because right now it's what, a teaser and like three trailers.
Well, no, no, don't forget the 5 second teaser to the teaser.
Yes,
right.
Yeah. I think so one teaser and one trailer might be good enough.
I do, because usually I find that the trailer that comes out usually like a couple weeks before the movie usually always gives away the third act. Mm. Like 9 times out of 10 always gives away the third act.
Oh, speaking of that. That Civil War trailer, that better not be the final. If that,
I'm hoping that's not
the final
battle.
Scene is in that parking lot, I will be pissed off.
I mean, it's a scene from Marvel vs. Capcom, the video game. They're all just flying at each
Look,
other.
Look, I'm totally fine with that scene being in the movie, but if that is the final act and the final part where they actually throw down, I'm going to be upset.
Yeah.
Let's put a little small bet. $5, it's the final scene.
Okay. I say five bucks.
Wait,
it
is final scene or final battle?
Final battle.
Final battle. Okay. Final
I say
battle.
It is not.
Okay.
You say it is?
I say it is.
I'm with Josh. I think it is.
Oh my God. I'm going to be so mad.
Hey guys, if you like this clip, click here to watch the entire episode. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel because it'll help you stay up to date with all the stuff we've got going on here at Collider.